Oh, the wall normal guys.
Wendigoon is a horror conspiracy theorist YouTuber with several million subscribers, has a dark past with deep ties to far-right extremism. Wendigoon is very publicly friends with Turkey Tom. He is friends with
Tom.
He is publicly friends with Shoe0nHead, who is a conservative masquerading as a leftist.
Wait, what?
A few days ago, I saw this video pop up in my YouTube feed. Bad conservative horror movies. And I was immediately intrigued. I love long video essays about stupid shit like this. But what I got instead was the worst attempt at a hit piece I have ever seen on YouTube ever. So sit down
video
and get
louder?
Comfy.
Should I make it louder?
Because it's time for an old-fashioned video response.
Is this good?
Now before we get into this video, I just want to thank today's sponsor. You. This video is sponsored by all of you who donate to me on Patreon.com.
Wait, Todd.
Thank you all
very much. I'm
sorry I didn't. I made you some cookies.
That's good? Okay.
These are just for the people who support me on Patreon. Oh. Only they get a cookie. Not you. I see you, freeloader. Anyway,
I've
been pretty busy lately
doing life things,
but when this went down, I was like, I can't not respond to this. But by the time I was done with the script, the man had already deleted the video.
Wait,
everyone
what?
Was downvoted to hell. But even though the video is gone, I still want to respond to it.
Also, I want to actually address something on the downvotes, because this right here, that's an extension, right? It actually doesn't display the dislikes accurately. For example, I have one video that's really disliked by a lot of people, where the extension says it's somewhat 600 dislikes or something, but the actual dislike, which I can see in my stats, is around 300. So it's actually not accurate, but it gives an estimate. You have to get the extension, right? Yeah, you do. You do.
It was downvoted to hell. But even though the video is gone, I still want to respond to it for three reasons. One, I am directly involved in this. Two, I'm tired of these type of people running their mouths. And three, this topic is pretty timeless. And that topic is what I like to call the war on normal guys. Last year, I wrote a script for a video.
The white monster again, based. He actually had an extra 30 minute on Wendigoon alone. Nux reacted to it and it's another 1 hour reaction. Oh my god. I want YouTube to give us our dislikes back. YouTube should give us our dislikes back, man. They 100% should.
With this title, and it was about the YouTuber Wendigoon being cancelled on Twitter. For those of you who don't know, Wendigoon is a popular YouTuber who makes video about true crime, horror, and cryptids. And no, despite popular belief, Wendigoon has nothing to do with gooning. Wendigoon is what most YouTubers
Unlucky.
Who don't make political videos should be. His channel is completely apolitical. I don't like clicking a video about iCarly and then having to listen to you about how much you hate Trump, or clicking a video about
I fucking love Wendigoon. Sam, is Wendigoon the one that did the videos on... Yeah, is that the one that did the videos on iCarly and stuff you talked about like a month back? Is that the guy? Oh my god. No? Okay. I got no idea. That's another guy. Okay, I don't watch Wendigoon. I actually have... I don't know the guy, actually. I gotta admit, I don't know who Wendigoon is.
Fallout and hearing you go off about how Joe Biden sucks. I don't care. If I wanted to hear milquetoast political opinions, I would watch my own videos. But no, despite being non-political, Wendigoon is a great channel. He has a good community, he's very positive, he's a Sunday school teacher, he has a beautiful wife, he's friendly, funny, and kind. Which of course makes him an enemy to the most annoying people on earth.
Of course.
Month after month after month, I would see threads on Twitter and on Reddit about how what a terrible person Wendigoon was. But when I would go searching for reasons why, there was really nothing.
Of course,
besides
there is nothing.
I simply do not like Wendigoon. He has bad vibes coming off him like stinky lines. The vibes on this guy have never been right. I live in the Bible Belt. He has the vibes of the kids who would have been comfortable saying racist and homophobic slurs and bullied me in grade school. He always gave me weird vibes.
It's
deeply
about his
vibes
from this
guy. I initially unfollowed him because I started getting weird vibes from him. There are evil energies surrounding this man. Wait, what'd he do? He used to be a youth
He's
pastor.
He's a sweetheart, actually, so it's just Twitter being a fucking stupid again.
It's rare
got
to see
it.
A youth pastor with good vibes. What did Wendigoon do? Honestly, a lot of it is just the vibes. I needed more. I needed
the vibes, guys. It's the vibes.
People disliked this guy. I needed real arguments. I needed a living soyjack meme with a pedo mustache and bisexual lighting to string up and beat like a piñata. Enter In Praise of Shadows, aka Zane, a leftist video essay straight out of the aging millennial hipster factory. Seriously, why do they all look like this? What genre of man is this? The mustache, the hair, the clothing, post-ironic neo-redneck? You know how some people talk about how women's taste in men gets all weird and f***ed up when they're on birth control?
I heard about that.
I'm gonna call them birth control hot. I'm in no position to talk about style. I still do my makeup like it's 2009. Zane is a horror movie video essayist who, for some reason, decided to randomly go after Wendigoon and several other popular YouTubers and myself. His video starts off with him complaining that he got a lot of hate for his take about the movie Hills Have Eyes.
The hill people can be representative of anything that you want them to be, really. They can be Native Americans, and the hills themselves can be allegorical of them being forced back onto reservations.
Oats movies.
You saw a bunch of cannibal mutants and thought of Native Americans? Anyway, he goes on to talk about how people were misrepresenting him and leaving rude comments.
The cruel and untrue things that you say about another person do in fact have direct impacts.
You know, he looks like the kind of guy that lives in a mobile home. Yeah, not a fucking van. What are they called in English? The... He is quiet. Volume up. I'm sorry. A camper. Yes, a caravan. In a caravan. A trailer. In a trailer park. Yes, he looks like the kind of guy that lives in a trailer park. Exactly. That's the one.
On them and the way that people culturally see them. Are these your own genuine original thoughts and criticisms that you have based on my actual words and things that I have done, or that maybe you haven't thought critically about what you were reading online, about other people?
And about how after this video, apparently a lot of his subscribers stopped watching him, and now he's poor and can't afford rent.
Unlucky.
There was a month last year where I only made $500 in ad revenue.
Why are you telling us this? Why? Is he trying to farm sympathy? What? Boohoo, you made money off of YouTube AdSense? Like, I'm sorry? Like, having YouTube as a job is not a privilege. Fucking Christ, I can't speak English. You're not entitled. That's the one. You're not entitled. It's a privilege. You are... Oh my god, I can't even speak anymore. It's not your right.
It's not your right.
Fuck! I'm messing up! Well, it's the first time catching one of your streams. Love your YouTube videos. Keep up the good work. Thank you, David. And Foxy, thank you for the follow. Take your time, you can do it. I can't. Yeah, a privilege, not an entitlement. Thank you! My brain actually shut off. That's the one. Making YouTube content is a privilege. You're not entitled to do it. It's... Yeah. I'm sorry that you only made $500 off of your YouTube ad revenue. Sorry. How about you make better content next time? Hi, Foxy. Dude needs to go cry in a corner. With that background, he looks like welcome to the internet. Please follow me, meme. I can't take him serious. Yeah, that's background is I don't fucking know what he thought. That 500 is now 5 cents.
I can't live off that.
Which, if you're at this point, you need to get a job, or at least a side job.
Yeah.
That's capitalism meritocracy. Either make better content or get a job.
I literally said, if you're complaining that you're not making enough money off of your YouTube ad revenue, which already you had to work on, like you already had to work hard for getting that YouTube partnership to get monetized, right? So you already did it this far, but now you're complaining? After you have achieved the privilege of getting YouTube ad revenue money, you're gonna complain about it?
If we get communism, you can be the community YouTuber. No, I'm just kidding. Your ass is going to the mines! Then finally, an hour into the video, he gets to the topic, conservative horror movies. But then suddenly, seemingly out of nowhere, it was like he accidentally uploaded a schizophrenic meltdown.
Chapter 4.
If you're not aware, Wendigoon is a horror conspiracy theorist YouTuber with several million subscribers.
I mean, that explains why I don't know about Wendigoon, because I don't watch a lot of horror stuff. That would explain why I don't know Wendigoon.
That, as you will hopefully come to see, should not be seen as the wholesome, southern-friendly dad persona that he has publicly constructed around himself in the past several years. And that, like many people who talk about being Christians as much as he does, has a dark past with deep ties to far-right extremism.
Ooh, this sounds pretty bad. He's not the heckum wholesome YouTube dad we all thought.
He's
what could he have possibly done?
There are
many
things
that are
red flags.
Yeah, what could he have possibly done? Sorry, I talked over the video.
YouTube
My
dad,
bad.
We all thought. What could he-
Not a horror fan, Kitsu. I am a scaredy cat. I am a fucking scaredy cat. I love myself psychological horror. I love myself psychological horror. For example, I love Higurashi no Nakokoroni. Or short, When They Cry, the anime. I love that one. But that's psychological horror. I love psychological horror. And gory. A little bit gory. But like, the paranormal shit, I don't fuck with. No, that shit scares me.
What have possibly done?
There are many things that are red flags that we could talk about, from the bizarre gun ownership.
Yikes! An American man owns guns? Not very heckin'
crazy! Elfenlied? Yeah, Elfenlied. I love Elfenlied. Like, Elfenlied scared me as a kid, though. I say kid. I watched it when I was a mid-teen, I would say I watched Elfenlied. When I've only seen a couple clips of Elfenlied on YouTube, bro, that shit had me... Bro, that shit was scary to me as a kid. But Elfenlied is really good overall. I watched it afterwards. Elfenlied is amazing. It's amazing. Amazing. Wait, bro, got 3 million subs and making 500? Wait, are you sure the guy we're talking about is the one with 5 million subs? He showed Wendigoon. Like, Wendigoon has the 3 mil subs.
Our gun ownership.
Yikes! An American man owns guns? Not very heckin' wholesome, Wendigoon. He goes on to talk about how Wendigoon is rich, and therefore he doesn't respect Wendigoon's opinion on media.
He became exceptionally well-
I watched it, actually. I watched it. I did watch it. I did get scared. It is scary. It is scary. I don't like it. I do not like it. Good movie, but shit scary. Shit is so scary.
Wealthy by the time that he was 19 or 20. I have no need or desire to hear 5 hours of opinions on Blood Meridian from a 21-year-old millionaire.
Okay, if you have no need or desire, don't watch it. Just go next! What? Just go next! What? What's he complaining about? What's he saying? Like, the don't? Yeah, that fucking don't? Kitsunero requests, no, no, stop.
Like, what exactly is the correct amount of money to have where your opinions still matter? Like, if you suddenly got a bunch of video views and a bunch of patrons like you want, would we be justified in dismissing your opinions on movies? This honestly just feels like a conservative's idea of what a leftist is. Like, it's not just about hating people for having money. Like, what is Wendigoon's position of power in relation to the means of production? Does he own a business? Does he have employees he's mistreating? Not that I know of, he's just a guy who makes YouTube videos, like you. Only difference is, he's good at it and makes money, and you're not, and you don't. Okay, for real though, there's gotta be more, right?
Right?
What crimes
right?
has Wendigoon
There's
committed?
More, right?
Well, to start, he committed the crime of having friends.
Wendigoon is very-
No! No, guys! Chat! We need to cancel Wendigoon right now. Chat, Wendigoon, we need to cancel him. Get to Twitter,
Hello,
go on.
Motherfucker.
Get to Twitter, get those tweets ready, we're canceling the guy. He has friends. Unheard of.
Publicly friends with Turkey Tom. They have been seen together on multiple occasions, and I've seen online-
Oh, they've been seen together. No! Having friends in 2024, oh nah, cancel. Yeah, get his ass out of here. Get his ass out of here. You don't understand. When you're going to stealing his ad revenue, so you've got to watch him to have the moral high ground. Ah, okay, I see. Not friends, not on my YouTube. Yep, he's just a carrot. Wait, yeah. I have seen online, we can't be friends with Kitsu, the German boy hates you.
Mentions that Tom was either at his wedding or at the very least was
How dare he?
They have been seen together. I have seen online mentions that he was at his wedding.
They?
He's saying this shit like Turkey Tom is wanted for murder and not like he just said some slurs on Discord when he was a teenager. Does this guy-
Whoa, he did something bad as a teenager? What? What? I thought we were all saints when we were teenagers. Holy shit, what do you mean?
That, like, unheard every of. Single person unheard who's ever of. Been friends with or spoken to? Hey, before you enter my house, I'm gonna have to go through your Discord history from 7 years ago. I was gonna say no, but I can see this guy doing that.
I hate it. Like, people actually do this, though, with Twitter, right? Like, people will look through your Twitter account that you've had for like 10 years and dig up something you said 7 years ago where you disagreed with one person on one topic, and that's why you need to be cancelled. It's so ridiculous. As far as my parents know, I was a saint as a teen. Well, I always thought it was goofy that people think they can't be friends with people they disagree with. Thanks. So I know, right? That's so stupid. Like, how are you gonna have any relationships ever if you can't disagree with anyone? Like, I can't say I have friends. Never mind. We need to move on. I don't have friends, chat. I can't talk about this. I don't have friends. Listen to me, chat. I do not have friends. Please don't cancel me.
Wendigoon is publicly friends with Donut Operator, and even retweeted a photograph of the two of them hugging.
No,
Donut Operator
no,
is a gun-crazed, no. very far-right YouTuber with 4 million subscribers. His content is very pro-state, pro-cop, pro-gun, and pro-death to people who don't share his beliefs propaganda. For example, one of his videos is titled, Predator Takes Shotgun to the Face.
I love the example he used is a literal pedophile being killed. He's very pro-death for people who don't share his beliefs. Take, for example, this pedophile. Is that what you mean by people who don't share his beliefs? Out of all the videos, why that one? You're not gonna find many people who are gonna be like, oh no, the poor child molester.
Yeah, like...
Well, maybe you will, but most people won't. Also, he's trying to act like the Donut Operator is just a complete simp for the police, and he's really not. Even in the screenshot you show in the background, there's like 3 whole videos in frame where he's clearly being critical.
Yeah, a bad shoot, Akon cop. Oh my god, the Akon cop! Why did he not use the Akon cop? Why did he not use the Akon pop video? That would have been such a good example here! That would have been such a good example! Like, have you all seen that? I swear you guys must have seen that. Where the- Oh my god, no, 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 no! No wonder he's not making any ad revenue money. He doesn't know how to make content. How did he ever get YouTube partnered? How did he ever get YouTube partnered? How?
Of the police.
For someone who supposedly is so very anti-government, Wendigoon seems very comfortable with a man who makes his living
wow.
worshipping violence committed by the state. And the only thing that one could reasonably gather from this picture
worshiping,
of them hugging
by the way.
Is that he too is a fascist bootlicker himself.
Actually, we can't reasonably gather anything because you haven't given us anything to gather. You label this guy very far right, and he might be very far right, but you haven't shown anything very far right. Like, take a step back and evaluate the bare basics of what you just showed us. Wendigoon hugging someone who thinks it's okay when a pedophile dies. Okay, but let's be fair. Maybe there's more. Maybe there's
maybe
something
there
worse.
Is. Maybe.
He is friends with Brandon Buckingham, a gun
no.
YouTuber who has been accused
no.
of threatening rape.
Okay, so
what?
First of all, let's rewind.
What?
This
what?
Guy is
what?
A gun-tuber. This just proved this man did absolutely no research. I'm talking like 2 seconds going to this guy's channel amount of research. And for those who are unaware, that rape thing is a complete lie. It is a complete lie made up by, sit down, Sneeko. Sneeko made that up, and Sneeko had to
fucking
apologize
Sneeko
and
again.
Admit it was a lie.
It's called like full circle. Back to Sneeko. This video is a huge self-report. It really is. It really fucking is. If you're saying something like that side is the source, yeah, circle jerk. Everything leads back to Sneeko!
Because it was literal slander. I just love how in his little bread tube tryout video, he uses Sneeko as a fucking source. I mean, it's not like his other sources are any better.
His other sources
being Reddit. He got like 90% of this information from a thread about Wendigoon in a drama subreddit called Our YouTube Drama. This man like borderline plagiarized Reddit comments. Source, PeePeePooPoo123 and Sneeko. Nice job on the research, you fucking hack. Also, I love the screenshot he's using. This you, bro? This you showing sympathy to someone whose grandfather is dying?
He has collaborated with
Right? Like, what? This has to be satire. This has to be satire. There's no way he's serious. This has to be satire, right? Like, there's no way this guy is serious about it, right? No way he does cute self-reporting like this. There's no way. There's no way!
Constantly makes money through the most morbid and shameful true crime content of showcasing the last minutes
it of people- It isn't. Yeah, like... The more we go into it, the more it feels like satire. You guys know what I mean? Even though, like, there was an apology, but, like, I mean, like, it feels like satire. That's how he's presenting it. Holy shit, but him being serious, how tone, I don't even know if it's tone deaf, how, like, self-tone deaf are you? Oh my god.
Before they are suddenly and unexpectedly killed.
So I don't know much about this guy, but
wait, I wasn't listening to this.
Someone whose grandfather is dying?
He has collaborated with Nick Crowley, who constantly makes money through the most morbid and shameful true crime content of showcasing the last minutes of people before they are suddenly and unexpectedly killed.
So I don't know much about this guy, but it seems like your issue with him is that he makes true crime content. I mean, personally, I'm not a huge fan of true crime content, but it's extremely popular on YouTube.
Yeah, like...
Crowley is similar to...
Like, I know a lot of people that love true crime videos on YouTube, like, what was the point? Like, what? The content is satire, but the tone is serious? Yeah, like, what is going on? It's fucking with my brain. No, yeah, what do you mean? It is ridiculous that you would think it can't be real, but yeah. Ugh, holy shit.
To Wendigoon.
Fan of true crime content, but it's extremely popular on YouTube.
Crowley is similar to Wendigoon, in that on the surface they seem fairly edgy, but clean enough. But then you notice that he follows less than 200 people on Twitter,
and
of them are the same circle with names like Wendigoon.
So what? So what? What's the point? Let me tell you all a secret, by the way. Let me let you in on a little... Twitter/X secret. The higher your ratio is, like, the greater the difference of followers to, like, of following to followers is, the greater your algorithm boost is. The greater your algorithm boost is. So, and if you don't really have that many people to follow on Twitter, what's the problem? Maybe he doesn't really use it. Maybe he just posts stuff but doesn't follow things. That's how I use TikTok, by the way. Or used to. I don't really upload a lot of TikTok content anymore. Like, I put shorts and TikTok contents out there, but I don't really use the app itself, you know? There's no issue with doing that. Holy shit. The fact we have a tough time distinguishing what is real, what is satire these days is a rather sad state of affairs. That is true. But... I think it's also more in specific cases like these, where we just don't know. I don't even know what to say. Well, maybe it's because he is not terminally online and has a life. Just maybe. It's not even good satire, which is even worse. Yeah, like, even if it was satire, it wouldn't even be good satire.
Plagued 200 people on Twitter, and among them are the same circle with names like Wendigoon, Plagued Moth, Turkey Tom, Mr. Ballin, and what? Donut Operator.
On the surface, they look clean enough to pass the vibe check, but then you look closer and notice he follows people who don't pass the vibe check.
These people hate the police, and yet they're always like, sir, I'm gonna have to take a look at that Twitter follow list. Just absolute cop behavior. ACAB includes the follow police.
Wendigoon is publicly friends with Brandon Herrera.
Wait. I just noticed, is she wearing the same shirt? I know, it's very similar though. I wonder if she did that on purpose. I wonder if she did that on purpose.
ACAB includes the follow police.
Wendigoon is publicly friends with Brandon Herrera, who has made jokes that implied that he was sympathetic with public shooters who killed leftists. I've also seen people insinuate that Herrera was with Wendigoon in the days of being part of the Boogaloo movement, but I cannot find substantial proof on if this is true or not.
Wow.
But I've seen several comments saying this. So online, it is-
He's seen several comments, so it must be true. Source, I've seen it online. Source, the internet. Source, I've made it the fuck up.
Is at least culturally believed to be true.
Hey guys, I heard Praise of Shadows f***ed a dog. No, I don't have any proof, but it's culturally believed to be true.
He is friends with Oompaville, a gun-obsessed content creator.
Oompaville! What the hell did Oompaville do? He's not even political whatsoever. I guess that's the problem, isn't it?
Yeah,
but
I guess
no, you're a bad person if you shot a gun even once. This is America. That's like saying you're a bad person if you ate a cheeseburger. His other example of Oompaville being bad is making videos about Nikocado avocado. As if anyone and their mother has not made a Nikocado avocado video. This is ridiculous.
I haven't yet. Chat, do we need to make a Nikocado avocado video at one point? Oh my god. Do we need to talk about Nikocado avocado, the joke of the internet? Oh, the true joke. We need to.
Mm. Has to be more.
He is friends with Mudahar.
Mudahar?
He's not?
Mudahar! Really?
He's friends with Mudahar.
If someone can't be friends with Mudahar, they can't be friends with anyone. That dude is like, so not problematic.
Yeah.
And has recently showcased a great deal of trans-
Of course he's including this which a lot of people just put a false narrative in. But oh my god, I can't.
Phobia in his most recent video.
Okay, nothing in Mudahar's video was transphobic at all.
Nothing. People said it was transphobic because of the caricature in the thumbnail. Which it isn't. Like, question mark?
Oh, I don't even know why I have to entertain this.
Right?
Simply talking about a trans person isn't transphobia, and I wish that we could, like...
It wasn't even about... It wasn't even about talking about a trans person. It was only about the thumbnail. People didn't watch the video. People did not watch the video.
Move past this and just treat trans people like human beings and not like these like delicate little angels that we need to like step on eggshells around. It's really f***ing weird.
Who argued against Andrew Tate being deplatformed from social media websites?
He believes in the concept of free speech for everyone. Wow. Just like the Nazis. This is what you're using to paint Mudahar as a bad person in order to paint Wendigoon as a bad person. You're running out of paint, bro.
Wendigoon is publicly connected to the Internet Historian, and has even appeared in his videos. The Internet Historian publicly said that his birthday was April 20th. It is not. And has only said that as a joke because that is Hitler's birthday.
Ah yes, April 20th. Hitler's birthday. There are no other jokes surrounding the number 420. It's a f***ing weed joke. It's like making a joke about the number 69. This is either extremely dishonest manipulation, saying April 20th instead.
There is unfollow Patrick. Hi. What the fuck?
Instead of the number 420, so people wouldn't notice. Or you are profoundly mentally retarded, sir. Who's the
yep.
He's a joke about 420 and automatically thinks Hitler.
Right?
Somebody with preconceived notions about others. Everyone is already a bigot, so everything they say is bigoted. Instead of the other way around.
Of course.
Looking at bigotry and coming to the conclusion that that person's a bigot. No, you have this hater tunnel vision, which is why you're coming to insane conclusions like this.
We could talk about the time that Nick Spheres did a video about the disturbing movie Iceberg, who is a great horror trans creator, and in the comments of her video.
Oh, in the comments of we're back in the comments again. Oh, okay, Wendigoon said something. Let me move over here, chat, for you guys to see. I just saw your reaction to the Survivor Island Man and Moon. Ay, ay! Hope you enjoyed it.
We will be watching your career with great interest. Which
yeah,
is
yeah.
kind of gross.
That is a lot.
Long- It's so gross to be complimenting someone. That's so gross.
From Star Wars. You really saw him being friendly with a trans person, the trans person being friendly back, and came to the conclusion that this was transphobia? For f*** sake, man, she oo-wooed at him. Have you ever sat back and thought, hey, maybe if I have to squint my eyes and tilt my head and glue my balls to my butthole in order to paint these people as Nazis, maybe they're not Nazis?
He has interacted positively with Garant Thumb, who has said, the traditional family should be-
He interacted positively with this person who said this thing on the internet, so he's a bad person. Mike Peek, chat is going crazy with a Mike Peek. Remember when she said no more Mike Peek? Yeah, I have it back on. Because I'm hot in this fucking room. This room is hot. I'm sweating. It's hot, guys. Let me enjoy my fan. I have noise suppression turned on so you guys don't hear the fan.
Encouraged and strengthened. I see little to no support from the government or big media.
No, no. Oh, let me move over so you guys can read it. Yeah, the traditional family, it should be encouraged and strengthened. I see little to no support from the government or big media. Okay? No way he said that. No way. How dare you? So controversial. Hi. Thanks for the follow, Bombay. Hi. 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 How you doing? How's it going? You're in for a live reaction. Welcome.
Be encouraged and strengthened. I see little to no support from the government or big media.
Traditional families? Not traditional families? No!
You need a mist fan? Does that exist? I don't even know. But there's 100% fans that are more silent, that are silenter, more quiet, quieter, that are quieter. That's the word that I was looking for. That are quieter than my fan.
No, this video was made for one type of person and that type of person only. Because what the are we supposed to be mad at that?
For yeah, someone who is supposedly clearly anti-government. He sure does seem to have a lot of wealthy white friends who actively work to uphold the values of the American Empire.
For someone who hates the government so much, they sure have a lot of wealthy white friends who hold up the American Empire. What the f*** are you saying? It's like lefty Mad Libs. He's just chucking a bunch of buzzwords at the wall and seeing what sticks. Capitalism, cops, white, American Empire. Again, he sounds like a conservative's idea of what a lefty would sound like. He sounds like a f***ing Daily Wire sketch character. He goes on to talk about more Twitter accounts Wendigoon follows and how some of those accounts have liked problematic tweets. Okay. Now, see, I always thought fascism was hyper-nationalistic authoritarianism, but apparently it's actually when you follow people on Twitter that Walmart Noah Samson doesn't like.
He has publicly interacted in a friendly way with the account Rock Solid on multiple occasions.
No. Responding to someone on Twitter makes you best friends with that person. Hey, by the way, this you be-
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no.
Being friendly with YouTuber Sophie from Mars, who is allegedly an abuser? Is that you, bro? Because according to your own logic, not mine, that makes you and her friends.
No.
Which makes you a bad person. And personally, I'd rather be friends with people who make jokes on the internet.
We love it when Shoe brings receipts, man. Aw, Shoe. You genius. Fucking call his ass out, man.
Internet than someone who allegedly put cigarettes out on their girlfriend's skin. But honestly, I wouldn't hold this against him. How is he supposed to know? You throw a dart into the crowd of these people and you're bound to hit a sex pest.
He is publicly friends with Shoe0nHead, who is a conservative masquerading as a leftist, who has built a career off of lazy anti-woke content complaining about SJWs, who says stuff like, Karl Marx rising from the grave finding out his movement has been taken over by fat, ugly, mentally ill losers.
No.
I mean, what's crazy is I could have given you like 20 examples of way worse shit I've said over the years, but instead you choose a random joke I made on Twitter. You just went to my Twitter and found like one of the last tweets I made. This you, Wendigoon? This you, bro? Congratulating someone on-
No, Wendigoon congratulated Shoe on her wedding? No! Cancel him.
On their wedding day? A conservative masquerading as a leftist is so funny too, because like, What? What would be the point of that? Am I waiting for like a Soros check? It would be way more lucrative as a woman on the internet to just be a conservative commentator instead of pissing off all sides like I do. Also, the term publicly friends with is so funny. He keeps saying it. And like personally, it's hilarious to me because I have to be privately friends with several public figures because they are prisoners to their own audience because their own audiences are full of people like this guy. So I have a lot of respect for people like Wendigoon who will just talk to anyone they want to and aren't scared of these cry bullies. Also,
yep. Honestly, respect. I am friends with my friends, and if you guys think my friends are problematic, yeah, well, fuck you. She was Kitsu's best friend.
Oh, I think it's important to say, Wendigoon and I talk on Twitter sometimes, but we're not like
yeah, friends. Oh, friends. No, I don't have friends. No!
Also, I think it's important to say, Wendigoon and I talk on Twitter sometimes, but we're not like best friends. I've never even met him in real life. But because he has the audacity to tweet
sweating
at
right
me,
now
all my opinions are his. And as for the lazy accusation, you got me. Honestly, this all would have bothered me.
No! A human being lazy? No! Shit, I'm lazy too! Oh my god, it's Jova for us. It's so Jova! It's so Jova, guys, no!
Me way more like a few years ago, but I'm so over it now. Go ahead and call me what you like. I take solace in the fact that every woke idiot that comes at me eventually gets their own ass cancelled into the shadow realm, and yet I remain problematic and a moron forever. And I personally can't wait until the inevitable day an army of skeletons comes marching out of your closet. What does bother me, however, is linking Wendigoon to me in order to smear him. My friends and
yeah,
I
like,
aren't
what the fuck?
A hive mind. And that-
Yeah, just because you are friends with someone doesn't mean you support all their views. Their relationship needs to have compromises. If you 100% agree with another person, it's not possible to have a 100% agreement with someone else. There's always gonna be someone. Ayo.
Regadsm just cheered 100 bits.
Thank you.
100 viewers hype.
Ayo! We had the 100 viewers! Hey, what the hell? It says 95 for me. But if that's 100 for you, hey! Oh my god, hi people, hi! Hi everyone! Hi! Can't wait for this guy with the weird mustache to come after you for being German and making weird connections to the American plan because you're a dumb fox or something. Yeah, I'm German and I watch Shoe. I watch Shoe and Shoe0nHead commented on one of my reaction videos to her that she likes my reactions. So we are besties. Me and Shoe are besties in this house, so I'm problematic and I need to be cancelled. Holy shit.
Might be easy for most people to understand, but not for these people. People like this guy, they don't have friends. They have enemies and they have temporary allies. They have people they hate and people they will eventually throw under the bus the second that person has a problematic tweet one day.
He has said many times publicly that he lives in East Tennessee.
No,
it is
no
about
friends,
as white
no
as
besties,
you-
no friends, no besties, no friends. I don't have friends. I don't have friends. Please don't cancel me. Please don't cancel me on Twitter. No, don't. I think it was the Twitch thought epidemic video. I think it was this one. I did pin her comment because it did make me happy.
Tweet one day.
He has said many times publicly that he lives in East Tennessee. It is about as white as you could possibly get. Deep Appalachia is very white country. And for the most part, is exceptionally racist. Genuinely in this part of the country, you have to assume that any white person you meet is racist unless they show you otherwise.
Holy shit! Okay, guilty until proven innocent. Okay. So guilty. Guilty until proven innocent. Okay, got it. Got it. And being white is a crime now, yes? Being white on Twitter has always been a crime, don't you know? Don't you know? If you are white on Twitter, your opinion doesn't matter. Have you never heard of that? What the fuck? Also, if you're a cis white male on... Like, if you're a cisgendered male on Twitter, your opinion also doesn't matter. If you're white, your opinion doesn't matter. If you're straight, your opinion doesn't matter. Like, no. No. Bad chat.
All white people from Appalachia are racist until proven otherwise. He's implying Wendigoon is low-key racist because of where he's from. He literally has no proof otherwise. No videos, no screen caps, nothing that shows Wendigoon being racist. But you see, he has to be. So because he's from Tennessee, he secretly must be. Making a broad negative generalization about somebody based on their race, but wokely, so it's okay. Appalachia is one of the poorest areas in the country. And aren't you a poor motherfucker too? I know you don't want to hear it, but the working class revolution is not just gonna...
He literally started the video with he only made $500 off of YouTube and he can't live with that. Now that's not a livable income. Oh, boo-hoo. Make better content! Get a job! Stop crying to people that already think... Like, people that consume YouTube videos already think you did get lucky. People already think you did get lucky. So you think YouTube audience will feel sympathy for you making $500... dollars off of YouTube? No, of course not. No one will give you sympathy for making money off of YouTube. People would be happy if they made $500 off of YouTube. Heck, I am happy I made $500 off of YouTube, man. That shit's insane to me. My mind is blown. Okay, that blew my mind. I am overfilled with the utmost joy by making $500 on YouTube. What the hell is he talking about?
It's gonna be full of the purple-haired Starbucks baristas. It's also gonna be Billy Bob the truck driver from Tennessee. And you have more in common with those guys than you do the rich bread tubers that you're trying to suck the farts out of currently. So why don't you drop the smug liberal attitude and show some class solidarity, comrade?
Then of course, there is his username. To the Algonquin people. The Wendigo is a negative spiritual symbol. He has attempted to deflect from criticism over the use of the name by saying that his grandfather was Native American. But I personally have to look at it from the hypothetical perspective.
He has to look at a username at the hypothetical thing. So, yeah. He has to look at it from a different angle from what it actually is. That's enough. Oh my god.
A black or mixed grandfather in this situation, and black people were telling me that I was doing something that was racist or offensive to them. I would then listen to what they were saying instead of claiming that I had the right to do it because I had some melanin in me.
I need to rewind to listen to this again. I need to rewind. No, we need to listen to this again. My brain could not comprehend what the fuck he was just saying. We are turning on the subtitles for what he's saying. It's serious! We're bringing out the subtitles!
Then, of course,
let me move them here so you guys can see them.
To the Algonquin people, the Wendigo is a negative spiritual symbol. He has attempted to deflect from criticism over the use of the name by saying that his grandfather was Native American. But I personally have to look at it from the hypothetical perspective, where, say I had a black or mixed grandfather in this situation, and black people were telling me that I was doing something that was racist or offensive to them. I would then listen to what they were saying instead of claiming that I had the right to do it because I had some melanin in me. Especially if I were more or less raised within a primarily white cultural area like the Appalachian Mountains are. And also on top of that, just, you know, frequently associated myself with white supremacists.
Whoa. Where was the white supremacy? He spent like 10 minutes smearing a bunch of people Wendigoon talks to, but...
Okay, so he's basically saying that Wendigo is doing the equivalent of saying he's not racist because he has... But because his grandfather is black, that's the equivalent. That's what he's saying. Like, that right? Because holy shit, what he was saying was so... What is he even trying to get at? Why is he even comparing those? Why? Like... No! 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 Azrael, hi! Welcome! Thanks for the follow. I'm not racist, I have black friends. He just compared that. He's just exposing himself. No, he said it was hypothetical. But still, he brought this up as a comparison for it. It's just like, what is he going on? Hi, I found you on YouTube. Hi! And we're in the middle of a new reaction video on top of that, so welcome in. Also, welcome in Grimmytex. Native Wendigo's grandpa is native. The commenter only said theoretically had a black or mixed grandparent. Yeah. Like, there is just no problem with Wendigo using that name. Firstly, that's a username. Secondly, his grandfather is of Native American descent, which makes him of Native American descent, even if it's getting watered down now. He is still a descendant of that. Like, what is he getting at? What the fuck? Found your content value. I hope your stream is going well. Thank you. Oh my god, chat's going so fast now. I have to leave for work, but I'm so glad to have met you and found your stream. Thank you so much! Enjoy work! Hopefully you got a not too busy day. Appalachia is mostly natives that didn't sell their land. Alright.
But not once did you show any white supremacy. Again, just haphazardly throwing around lefty buzzwords. White supremacy!
We could talk about his past.
Yeah, and on top of that! And on top of that, he just brought in white supremacy out of nowhere!
Founding member in an online conspiracy theory group. They talk about his past and supposedly being a founding member in an online conspiracy theory group that, according to him, snowballed out of control into being a white supremacist neo-Nazi organization called the Boogaloo Boys. In 2020, they killed several police officers in a drive-by shooting in Oakland, hoping that black people would be blamed for the violence, in an attempt to create racial tension.
So basically, Wendigoon was part of a libertarian group that eventually became more extreme and radical over time, and he no longer agreed with the goals, so he left it and he disavowed it.
Okay.
Isn't that what you want? For him to own up to his mistakes and take accountability? You'd have a point if he was still involved in this group, or even if he was part of the group while the group was doing all these terrible things, but... he wasn't. It's so funny he had to add this completely made-up factoid that the Boogaloos killed cops in order to blame it on black people, but I couldn't find that literally anywhere. In fact, I found the exact opposite. The Boogaloo Boys made sure people knew it was done by them. And it wasn't to spark a race war, it was to spark more anti-government sentiment. The Boogaloo Boys are a radical libertarian group. They hate cops. So I think this guy made up this thing about them wanting to blame black people so people in his audience wouldn't think the Boogaloo Boys were cool. Yeah, they killed cops, but not in the based cool way we want to kill cops. This is probably the most damning evidence they have against Wendigoon, even though he's not involved in this group anymore.
Yeah,
like, but they still fucked it up. Zane was liking tweets from people, glazing him, telling him what an amazing job he was doing for finally going after Wendigoon, our glorious Reddit white knight, basking in the attention and glory of finally slaying the bad vibes dragon. All while Wendigoon left a nice comment on the guy's video, telling people not to be mean to this guy.
Aww.
Well, that sign won't stop me because I can't read. One comment I found-
But the comment section is the guy's favorite place to be. What was his name again? Donut? Donut's favorite guys to be is the comment section. Why is he ignoring this comment? I don't understand.
Found on this guy's video was like, loving the Wendigoon fanboy is trying to deny that he's conservative. He'll get away with it, because he's popular though. He'll get away with it. Get away with what? The crime of being popular online while not agreeing with you politically?
No.
Is that what this expose is about? Wendigoon exposed, not a communist.
Wendigo has friends. Wendigo is friends with Shoe0nHead. Shoe0nHead commented on Kitsu's video. Kitsu is German! That makes Wendigo a Nazi! It's all come full circle. We have figured it out. Cancel Wendigo now. Chat! We need to cancel Wendigo.
Nobody gives a sh**.
So what if he's a conservative? Is that a problem? Which, the answer to that is yes. But the reason that I care is because this does not belong in horror. Or anywhere. I care deeply about horror. And everything that he does has demonstrated so far in his career that he should not be welcomed in our spaces. Or even, you know, just in public in general.
What?
Okay. Yeah, like what?
First of all, I assure you nobody wants to be in your space, bro. Imagine the smell. But second of all, in public?
You had what's my turn. My head hurts too. Oh my god. This video is amazing. Holy shit. Ow, 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 I hit my knee again. Ouch. Oh my god. That is... Wow. Good job, Shu. Roast the bitch. Roast him.
When did nobody...
Just in public in general.
What? Okay, okay. First of all, I assure you nobody wants to be in your space, bro. Imagine the smell. But second of all, in public? Wendigoon should not be allowed in public spaces. Wendigoon should not be allowed to exist in society because he is Twitter friends with people this guy disagrees with on Twitter.
Should not be accepted within society at all. They should not be celebrated. They should be treated for what they are.
Motherfucker, slim boy, hi! Also, I need to rewind this because I didn't catch this because I looked at chat. I was talking. Sorry for talking over the video again. Go static, yeah! Need a go static.
Twitter friends with people this guy disagrees with on Twitter!
Should not be accepted within society at all. They should not be celebrated. They should be treated for what they are. Because remember, kids, when somebody shows you who they are, believe them.
Well, you've told us you're a lying, manipulative hack, and I believe you. But Wendigoon's actions, words, and even comments he left on your video tell us he's a good person.
Yeah.
You're so lost in the sauce, you don't even realize all you did to the average viewer was make this guy seem like a kind person who learns and grows from his mistakes. These flimsy accusations and guilt by associations may work for the NPCs in your audience who already hated Wendigoon based on vibes, but you need to bring more to the table than unsourced Reddit comments. If you're trying to convince the average person who isn't terminally online that this guy deserves to be ostracized from society. The fact is, most people have friends they don't politically agree with. Most people make edgy jokes. Many people are into guns. Many support the police. No. And most enjoy when pedophiles die. These things are listed as like crimes Wendigoon's friends have done in order to smear Wendigoon. Do not make them fascists or Nazis. They make them normal people.
No way.
At the end of the day, this was just a witch hunt against a normal guy. But to these people, that is the enemy. The normal guy. They can dress it up however they want, but at the end of the day, that's what this video was. An attack on normal guys. And it's always been a war on normal guys. But hey, I'm glad you deleted the video. Hopefully you learned from this, but according to your Discord messages, you have-
Oh no, what does it say? Let me make myself small so you guys can see too. Oh yeah, nobody in the video has actually refuted any of what I said, lol. They only point out small individual things that are wrong, but don't actually go so far as to say that what I said wasn't right. Sure, buddy. Sure. Like, I 100% believe that he believes this. I 100% believe that he believes this. He's so caught up in his own delusion, man. What is going on?
Anyway, that was that video. I just really wanted to stick up for someone who absolutely did not deserve all the hate.
He really doesn't.
Thank you again to everyone who donates to me on Patreon.
Yeah, Wendigoon really doesn't deserve the hate from what I hear. Like, again, I don't know Wendigoon. I don't watch his content because I'm not a big fan of horror content, but goddamn, what the fuck?
You help so much. And I will see you all real soon with a new video.
Yay!